We just released a 13.5 pounder. Wayne did. And his son Talon has already caught a 10, a little over 10 pounder. And then we got another one on. Didn't even let another line out. We already got a fish on.
We're killing them.
It's just, I'm lucky or blessed or both. It's, sorry if I got Copenhagen all over my face. Bad habit, the only bad habit I have. Quit drinking about a year ago. And sometimes I miss it.
Yeah.
It's nice to have a 3 or 4 beers and forget about the whole world for a couple hours. But for health reasons, I stopped. I didn't think I would quit Copenhagen because of health reasons.
Where are we at? Tell them what's the numbers.
120.
Still way down there?
Yeah. It felt like he's almost swimming toward us.
Yeah. Keep drilling. Keep up on the surface. You could have a brown. The way he was acting, he seemed a little bit more feisty.
Mm-hmm. Still that way the entire time, yeah.
Water temperature's 40 degrees. Air temperature's probably 40 degrees. A little bit chilly. I'm still in my big fart suit, coveralls. This one come on a Rapala F13 in a cutthroat pattern. Right on the surface. And you're on top shot, so there's nothing left. You're in the middle down. He's acting like a max. You're fine. I'm working around here. Are you going or?
Yeah, you just ran some.
I got the Daiwa Alexa 300s and a Claris 8.5 foot, medium heavy, fast action. Perfect setup for these flakers and big brown. That rod's actually brand new.
How are you guys running? Still
running a little. The way he's staying down, I would say it's a lake trout, aka Mackinac. I think we're 70% of snowfall now for the year. Not a lot of snow down here at lake level, which is about 5,900 feet. Today is actually supposed to be warm. That climate change, you know. Here we're warm over here, and what was it, a week and a half ago? Texas was, you know, in 20 below or something crazy.
Yeah.
I forget how cold it was. Wild weather going on.
Where you at, Talon?
18.
All those diesel trucks running. Are ruining everything.
Running.
He's taking off. That's a Laker.
About back to 30 now.
That's what happens, folks. Talon can call himself a local now. He's living up there at Soda Springs. They're in the snowy country.
I think he's coming up now.
Yeah, he might have given up.
Well, all of a sudden he's... Says 900 more feet to go now.
But then you click the...
Rolled over.
Clicked it. Just staying right under the boat. So what they always do, we end up going round and around in circles on these guys. Everybody that watches my videos, they all say, you know, they're like, yeah, that's what he says every time.
I
frog now.
You've heard that before, huh, Talon?
Yeah. Yeah, he's going under.
Typically, this time of year, the lake has at least some sheet ice on it, and it hasn't happened yet. It may still happen. Here, second or third of this month, they're forecasting below freezing nearly all day for a few days in a row, so we may start getting some ice. This may be the last trip for me for a while, until spring. But anytime you can get out here this time of year, it's usually worth it. Thursday we got a 16 and a half pounder, and it wouldn't surprise me if this fish here we got on the line's bigger. So you run into this situation sometimes where, it's a fine line between fighting them too hard and bringing them up too fast. So put a little bit more heat on them, a little more drag on the reel. Get this fish in the net and weigh him, let him go. He's like, stay right under that. There he went. Oh, he's angry. He's angry.
A nice fish, I think.
It is a nice fish. We have these breaks in the weather, and these fish, they get hungry. They stop hanging off the bottom and come up.
That was on the downrigger? Yeah. No, the last one was on the downrigger.
That was right up on the surface. 8 feet deep. About 3.2 miles an hour, 200 feet of line out. You know, it's about 8 foot dive on those Rapala, something like that, 8-9 feet. He's still pulling. Very far down there, is he?
I don't think so.
No, you got a lot of top.
Lift him up, reel down.
Well, I saw that might be him right way up there on top. He's only about 10 feet down. He just doesn't want to come in. We don't have too much drag on him. Worst thing you can do is put too much drag on these fish. He's burping bubbles. That's good. See the bubbles hit the water right there?
Yep.
He's took a good dive.
There you go again.
Yeah.
No, keep reeling. Keep reeling. Stop. Stop. Okay. Should be able to get him right here. He is. More bubbles. Hey, he looks like the same fish. 12, 13 pounds. He's a hard fighter. Go down again, isn't he?
Yeah. Pulling down pretty good. He's going.
And people say they don't fight hard. He's gonna give up. Takes longer than you want it to. One one fish the young kid caught went from 30 feet all the way to 130 feet. Going under the boat on the skin, isn't it?
Wow, going hard now. Just a good run.
We probably caught this one before. He doesn't like it. So I think the tally's up to 112 or something. This will be 113 fish over 10 pounds that caught out of this lake and let go. Although some of them don't make it, the percentage is really small. I think we've only lost maybe 8 or 9 fish over the years. Sometimes they fight themselves to death. A lot of big fish in this lake. Caught them several times, some of them. Yeah, pump them up. Pump them drag. That fish is fighting hard, like he's hooked in the gill plate or something, you know? Finally got him. Oh, he's gonna rip that lure out. Hey, he might be 15.
Right on 15 pounds.